With a standard size beef carcass, traditional cutting techniques are used. This includes the removal of the rib, sirloin, fillet and rump muscles, which will go into traditional butchery cuts. With a larger carcass, some of the issues that arise are steak cut sizes. If someone wants an 8-ounce steak from a large muscle, it will have to be cut thin, and this can lead to an inconsistent cooking experience. This issue can be alleviated by adopting alternative cutting techniques, resulting in a more consistent product. AHDB provide advice on a range of techniques, which are ideally suited to larger carcasses. Industry feedback suggests that issues with larger carcasses include pack size, where large steaks don't fit a standard size pack, and resulting in a loss of yield to make the product fit. From a consumer's perspective, a thinner steak is harder to cook to medium or medium rare, resulting in a poorer dining experience. Rib. The rib has to be deboned to produce the ribeye, which has a larger surface area in comparison to a standard ribeye. The ribeye is then split down the middle and can then be cut into a more consumer-friendly steak. It will be slightly thicker, but with a smaller surface area, meaning that it can more easily be cooked to medium or medium rare. Sirloin. We remove all back fat and gristle, which gives us a fully denuded muscle. This can be cut lengthways to produce sirloin cannon steaks. Again, these can be cut thicker, giving a more consistent product and cooking range to the consumer. Fillet. The fillet was trimmed with the chain off, but was otherwise cut as a standard fillet. Rump. On larger rumps, you can use a three-muscle method. The cap muscle is removed to produce the pickhanna. The remaining muscle is split down the middle with the gristle removed. This leaves the bistro and prime rump steaks. By adopting this method, you'll have removed all excessive fat and gristle, resulting in a more consistent product. Yields were produced for the large and small carcass. Based on the figures and findings from our research, a potential increased profit of more than £320 per carcass could be achieved using this alternative butchery method. For more information, including cutting guides and a downloadable leaflet on turning larger livestock into profit opportunities, visit our website.